Dear Senator Terpstra, beste Gerrit, thanks a lot for hosting this this meeting. Thanks a lot for your kind words, and to all, I will remember what you told your wife, and so the next time I will do some more demands in your direction. Don't be afraid. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, great to see you all of you, so many who have given posteriority today to other obligations and came over to this seminar. Welcome to you, willing to offer your extensive expertise and your immense professional experience to the meaning and deepening of this orientation of today. An orientation about, and as we intend, a contribution to the perspective about the vital relation between ethics and finance. A contribution as well to the debate of the last 2.5 years, initiated by UNIAPAC, the Christian Employers Organization in Europe and worldwide, facilitated and strengthened by the Konrad Adenauer Foundation from Frankfurt to Beirut, and from Paris to Milan, Brussels and Rome. And now, with gratitude to the organizations mentioned and the Konrad Adenauer Foundation, especially here in The Hague. Inspired as well and oriented by the Pontifical Commission for Justice and Peace. No misunderstanding. This commission, as some of you might fear, doesn't act ex cathedra, but invites and consults the highest level of experts from all over the world, some of them present here today. In the Netherlands, we could cooperate with VNO-NCW, the Netherlands Employers Organization, especially with the division which has developed a tradition of reflection and orientation on the relations between business and ethics. Business and faith, as is expressed in the yearly Bilderberg conferences, the monthly reflection lectures, and the working group on religion and entrepreneurship. In the best, sometimes forgotten traditions of Adam Smith, who was foremost an ethicist. But this initiative is also the fruit of a communication with the so-called Nachten van Geld en God, Nights Forgotten Money, as facilitated by Frits Goldsmeding, the founder of Randstad, on his clip. Last but not least, we are also motivated by the excellent issue on economy of Christendemocratische Verkenningen, the quarterly of the Academic Institute for, not of the CDA. Of this issue, economy as a service for the good life, are some copies available on the table of publications at Entrance Hall. And there is also the book of our keynote speaker, Dr. Steven van Akkelen, about the 7 capital sins in politics and society. Dr. van Akkelen is available to sign his book after his symposium, under the condition that you pay for it, of course. And the same applies for the subscriptions for the which I recommend vividly for Christian Democratische Verkenningen. But all these forms of cooperation and assistance do not necessarily guarantee a symposium with real added value or a specific, distinct angle. Added value amidst the tsunami of publications and opinions and outcries about the failure of the financial and banking industry. So Sirius is, after all, not a finance lab. It is a reflection and orientation platform about what contributes to a responsible, better maybe responsive, society in our days. From exactly that angle, we can probably still have a distinctive contribution. No, it is not just ethics. A plea for, as some might expect, of just conversion of individual bankers and the banking sector as a whole. A conversion from greed and irresponsible risk-taking. And we are even not a next voice in the choir of bankers bashing and prophetic longing for a world without selfishness and immorality, unfair competition, and a practice of what is not strictly legally forbidden is permitted. Of course, these observations and analyses are many times true and recommendable, but you do not need a symposium like this today to underscore that fact. Because the question remains, and then? And how to proceed further? What we are looking for, what we are searching together, with all those dialogues, as I have mentioned, is the answer to the question, is there a comprehensive approach beyond the merely technical and above all regulatory plans and programs, beyond as well just the ethical condemnation of practices and attitudes? Is there, in other words, a twofold approach to the challenges of the financial industry and the indispensable banking sector, and to the well-being of the society as a whole? We are looking first to the combination of indeed improvement of individual ethics, second place, a change of culture within and of the institutions, third place, with a regulatory reform internally and externally, fourth, with a fundamental financial architecture, politically, societal, and effective, even on the multilateral and global level. This combination, this comprehensive approach, should be first and foremost on our agenda. But how complicated this already might be, these specific four elements of this approach have to be considered individually and worked out and deepened beyond the slogans and wherever it is not done enough and white spots left. And that's the secret here. For instance, ethical conversion. Integrity can never be bought nor regulated, says in the reader, which was available for preparation of this seminar, the former chairman of the British Employers Organization. What are then the preconditions and the fostering elements which are really working? Change of culture. What does it mean for the boardrooms, for the shareholders, for the public opinion, for all of us, as Gerrit Terpstra explained? Closing loopholes. How to realize in a global system that becomes more and more complex. And regulations. Where are the limits? But especially, where do they stop? And trust begins. This symposium will not give the answers. It is just an extension of the dialogue, which started 2.5 years ago in Frankfurt by Union Park. This meeting should be foremost a dialogue of high-level financial and economic experts with ethicists, theologians, and politicians. Also, our country, our Dutch society, deserves and needs such an encounter. If it meets its expectations, then we will continue it as a part of a series about specific issues and white spots. Please indicate today which items you think that should be dealt with as elements for a really relevant agenda for our follow-up. Because, dear friends, as Mark Carney, the governor of the Bank of England, again in our leader, says, quote, "Our sons and daughters are taught not that financial crises are inevitable, but that they are avoidable and tremendously costly for jobs, growth, and prosperity. I wish you, in this approach, broad and comprehensive about the relation and the combination of ethics and finance, a fruitful dialogue."